is our God.
Amen.
Church, are you happy to be here?
Yes, sir.
Amen. Before I call out the pastor, I just want to wish all the moms, especially those that are here and those on social media, happy Mother's Day. Mm-hmm. You know, we love you guys. We appreciate you guys. Thanks for being there for us through good times and bad times. You know, without you guys, we won't be where we are right now. So we just wish you guys happy Mother's Day. We love you. Amen. Well, now, again, please join me now and call God the pastor. Amen. Put your hands together.
God bless you, sir. God bless you. How are you? Can I be the wife?
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
At least my dressing code should be speaking. You mean, is that the one? The wire might be the problem. My dressing code is a kind of wire. The wire might be the problem. Change wire. No, not you. My dressing code already proves that this is a special day. Mother's Day. Mother's Day program. Mother's Day. So by His special grace, we give God all the glory for giving us another opportunity to appreciate our mothers. Does that make sense?
Amen.
We are so blessed to have them around us. And when I was asking my wife this morning what are her plans for today, she said the message you are teaching will do us mother good than us, you know, doing our activity. But as long as I'll give them opportunity to. So, Mother's Happy Mother's Day. We really appreciate you for all your work. Forget about it. There's nothing on earth. There's nothing on earth. I'm telling you the truth. It's only after God. You know, you are the sweetest thing that can ever happen to a man, that can ever happen to a family. You know, do you know the problem that people do have with mothers? You, especially, my boys, are you listening? Youth? If you look at the abilities of a mother, of your wife, you will make a mistake. If you try to follow them based on their abilities. Number one, they are stronger than men, but men doesn't, you know. Because men we have muscles, we think we are strong. Their own strength is from the inside. I'm telling you. One of the best messages I've ever listened about women, his message preached by Bishop Bimbo Ado. And that topic was, how weak is this weaker vessel? Was a question. And honestly, the question she was asking, more than 20 questions, I couldn't answer it. How weak is this weaker vessel? Women that are passing through abuse, family abused, where their husband abusing them. Sometimes they can be with pregnancy. And their husband will be abusing them. And yet the one side, they hold the baby, protect the baby. And yet the man will be kicking, doing. See, how weak is this weaker vessel? A woman from the first day she got pregnant, pains. But she'll be using it to cook. She'll be using it to do everything. How weak is this weaker vessel? A man will be doing everything. Go, you know, in African culture, a man can go outside and mess up with another girl. And it will not be a news. It will not be something. You know, but when a woman does it out of, I read people that we are 96 years, The man was 96 years. The man was 96 years. The wife 92. So the man now filed a divorce because he found out that when the wife was 60 years ago, the wife. How weak is this weaker vessel? In African culture, they protect the men, like in the Bible too. You say the woman committed adultery, they stone her. And Jesus checked them. Where is the man that committed adultery with? He wasn't there. See, how weak. But if you are a man, my children, listen to me. Please, never, ever, ever treat your wife, especially my boys, based on their abilities. It will confuse you because they are stronger than you. But please treat them according to their nature. Does that make sense? Their nature is different from their abilities. The abilities, what they can do, what they are supposed to do, please. Potentials in them, forget it. But treat them according to their nature. See where we make mistake. What's their nature? They came with the blessing of their first husband. He that findeth a wife, findeth a good thing. Treat them according to their nature. What are their, what is it? The nature is that they like, they are straight. They are straight when they want to bless you. They are straight when they want to kill you. Treat them according to their nature. Their nature is that whatever you sow in their womb, they give it back to you. If you sow love, beauty, it's my wife. Sometimes I keep on sowing seed in her womb, but she thinks I'm... Then she gets angry. I say, I'll call the police. Call the police for you. This is too much love. I said, it's not for you. Because I know your nature. I have to feed that womb. Otherwise, look at what happened to Eve. Because the husband was not feeding the womb. When the devil came and said, because she has not had anything for that week, she said, I accept. Am I making sense, church? Mm-hmm. Treat them according to their nature and you will enjoy naturally what they came with. I failed in everything. And I have also, I don't care what else I will fail in. But if I will not fail in my marriage, I'm going to meet the master with boldness. If I will not fail in my family, when those that during their ministry got private jet and they are going to meet the master with joy, I will go with a greater joy. See, the man that cannot look after his own family, how can he be able to look after the church of God? Are you getting it? So make sure you get my picture, because this is Mother's Day, huh? The way I dress. Ubingana, you know? Amen. Church, are you happy?
Yeah.
So let's give another beautiful clap. Did I say something that you grasped within these few minutes? Otherwise, you will be teaching. Can you share with me, anybody, what did you learn? What did I say about women that you've learned tonight?
We should appreciate that. Their nature.
Their nature. And not what?
Not their ability.
Good! And what? What are their abilities? You know very well. What are the abilities you see in your mom? They are too much. It's too much. They are shock absorbers. They can endure. They will be on the other side, be crying, but when they see you, they so many abilities, but please, I beg you, remove your eyes from there. Because if you focus on their nature, you will not only enjoy their natural gifts, you also enjoy their abilities. Does that make sense? Their nature, respecting their nature and treating them based on their nature, we do what? The byproduct is what? Them releasing their abilities. Remember, one of the things God told me. Let's test it, whether it's happening. He said, Idika, you see your wife? Because he told me something. That was when he was telling me about Archbishop Margaret Bessie. Why he's using Archbishop Margaret Bessie. He said, because now is the season that if any man will honor his wife, he said he will prosper the person 3 times more than the normal. Because this is the end time. He was showing me Eve, a day before the holidays. This is time for women. And immediately he said that I picked it. Do you know what late Reverend Dr. Adebonye told me when she came to Malaysia? He said, you know, women ministry, Idika, you are very rich. Women ministry. See, Malaysia, it was like you were raising husbands. Great. Now here, God has given you. See, you are very rich. And it was a confirmation. Now look at it. Now, how will somebody come and say, if this is true, that all the prosperity that God has given us, that it was because I'm an Igbo man, I'm a businessman, strong. I depended on her nature. And her nature is now bringing the abilities to be where we are today. Are you getting it, church? Happy Mother's Day. And God bless you. I wouldn't want to take much of your time today because we are still on the topic, the characters of the next judge to deal with what? Coronavirus. We were in three and coronavirus ran away in our state. Is that not true? Remember the foundational scripture, and he sent forth his word. This is not a time to be looking for money or doing this. Start speaking the word of God. Start teaching the word of God. Reverend Dr. Esther, I can't forget her. That's why I'm dedicating this Mother's Day to her. She told me a lot of things. She said, Idika, is there anything that is not happening in your church? Is there anything that is not happening in your church? Teach it. Send forth the word. The word will heal it. Is there anything you want to happen in your church? Use the word of God, teach it, and the word will bring it. I've told you, what's the function of the Holy Spirit? To intercede. What's the function of the blood? To fight, touch not, speaking blood. What's the function of the word of God? To create. That's why three of them have to be walking in your life. So when we saw coronavirus, what I said, and he sent forth his word. And his word delivered us from coronavirus. Why worry when you can pray? Trust in Jesus and he will lead the way. Don't be like the doubting Thomas and worry. When you can pray, I can't fail in life. It can never be hard in life that I have high blood pressure or I'm sick. Oh! And on Schwarzenegger one day made a very powerful statement. Said, we are going to do this, we are going to do that. But somebody came to him and said, I'm looking for somebody that can do this. I'm looking for somebody that will help me. And they directed me to you. Who was the governor? And he said, congratulations. God bless you. But I think the person you are looking for is not this man. It's the one upstairs. It's Jehovah. Man, there are things I don't even give a second thought about. When it comes, I'll wait. Does it belong to me? I'll look at it. If it doesn't belong to me, why worry when you can pray? Trust in Jesus, and he will lead the way. Don't be like the doubting Thomas. And worry. When you can pray. Does that make sense? I'm telling you, if this thing happened in my life, when I'm crossing over, when I'm dying, I'll be dying laughing. If my children will remove every of their confidence from me and my wife and put it on Jehovah. If I get that achieved, I will not be afraid of any coronavirus that will come after I have left. I will not be afraid of any problem, because none of them will fail. See, for the fact you have made the Lord your stay. You know, there's a scripture that is almost unbelievable, but it's very true. That scripture is almost unbelievable, but it's very, very true. Psalms 112, verse 7. Can somebody read for it? It's almost. Mashallah, brother. Are you there? Anybody?
Verse 7?
Yes.
Psalms 112, verse 7.
Mm.
He shall not be afraid of evil tidings.
Another version that says bad news.
His heart is fixed.
No, it's okay. Another version. There was a day I put this on Facebook. I'm telling you, almost all the first world country pastors reacted against it. I said, shut up, remove that. They reacted against it. Read it again, read it.
Different versions, or he will have no fear of evil news.
He will have no fear of evil news. It means throughout your life, from the day you have made the Lord your stay. Why? What's the reason?
His heart is fixed, for his hope is in the Lord.
Because his hope is not only in the Lord, fixed. It means he cannot move. This thing is almost impossible, but it's very true. The word of God, be it unto you according to your faith. And I'm telling you, all the reverend ministers, all the bishops in Australia, America, they started saying, what do you mean? I've been faithful to God, I'm an archbishop, I'm a this, but why did this problem come to me? Problem is not a problem. It's the way you see it that makes it a problem. For all things work together for good unto those that love God and who are they called according to his purpose. There's no problem. When you are taking an exam, is he a problem? When you move to a new level, you see the new devil, is he a problem? That's examination, for goodness sake. Without exam, will you ever get a certificate? So examination now is problem. It's an examination to move, tell you that, to introduce to you your level of IQ, EQ, and spiritual intelligence. Am I making sense?
Mm-hmm.
Well, but all of you, you go to school more than me, you are more educated more than me, because you schooled in a first world country. Is my English too bombing and too machine gunning? You know, when I woke up in the morning and hear my children discussing, they don't know that's the reason I come to their room to listen. Good English, boy, now wow, he has good English. It's not this my own. So therefore, bottom pot. So take care of saying that. Mashiki Tiago, Liba Honda Hamaha. Characters. The late judge. See, we have dealt with it. What I'm teaching you is how you deal with it. Look at, I'm like the general in commander, major general, field marshal. Jimmy's on training to move the church to Canaan land. Soon I'll be leaving it, because when you carry somebody at the back, at the time you left him walk on his leg. But when coronavirus came, I said, Jimmy, this is an opportunity. Give me the chance. Let me deal with coronavirus. Let me show you how to deal. How did I deal with it? And he said, bring the word of God. Be an example. You have a covenant with God. just like Jim. God said nothing will kill you. And in the next, God said nothing will kill you, even to the next 50 years. You are sure of it. You are confident. An attack is coming to kill your sheep. Remember your covenant with God. Nothing will kill you. What is the wise thing to do? You come out and defend your sheep because your life is already sure, 100%. And you do it because you are the next judge. God can never lie. He has cast a line with me. I can't die. There's nothing. I still have a journey unless Jesus dies. But if it doesn't happen, we still have 20,000 statues to build. If it doesn't happen, we still have an academy in Biafra land to build. Am I making sense?
Yeah.
The God can never lie. And I came out. I said, watch me. Follow me as I follow Christ. Nothing will ever happen to you. No power will disorganize you. No power will destroy you. Look at it. Coronavirus has not. And saw that this is the man there is, you decapitate yourself. He says he's a troublemaker. Let's run away. Let's run away because any attempt, this guy will raise the dead. Any attempt, this guy will raise the dead. And people, they will win more so, more than not. You are the next judge. Stop waiting. Jesus is doing something. What is he doing? Did I share with you the other day?
Marriage.
He's preparing his marriage. Where is he living? That was I said, other people doing. Are there? Yeah, keep on planning your marriage. That's rapture. If you miss it, one thing that is going to baffle you, that's the difference between when we now go to the second death. We now have second coming. In that rapture, you'll be eating fish, meat. I don't know how it's going to happen, no. But he knows how to do everything. We will enjoy anything. It's not about you eat natural thing. You do. He says, wait. Do you remember when he was giving Holy Communion? He said, it will not happen again to me until when? When we are there, we drink wine again. He said, it will not happen. This one is the last one. We are going to drink and eat until rapture. Don't miss it. I told you who are the people that are qualified, who qualified to live the life of Christ after rapture? The Jews. Praise the Lord. Amen. So, in this teaching, I'm going to teach. We've done the first one, first character. The Bible says, when the children of Israel sinned against God, and what happened? When those that lived, outlived, that did. Those that saw the miracle God did with Moses, miracle God did with Joshua, when they died, the children of Israel went ahead. They left God. That's why I keep on saying, I keep on mentioning it. You know, I wrote something, I mean, it was just me and my wife, there are people that, how do I people, people that have been taken in Nigeria, in Church of God Mission. They are youths like me. We work together, we are youths, the same men. But if you see the way they are being celebrated, you know, I told my wife, look at the kind of question. We were just going through his Facebook, what he was asking, the question he was asking. And I told my wife, even Jimmy himself will answer this question. But he's saying that this is, and the question he was asking, why is it that Jesus said that the kingdom will come? Why has it not come? In Mark chapter 9, verse 1. He was asking why. I said, sweetheart, you see that? Look at their level. What will they be teaching? And in one of the questions, he now said something that was very controversial, but I told him, the judgment day will answer this, because there's nothing I will tell him that will, but the judgment day will answer this. But that has to explain why it's happening that people think that born again is salvation. Because the question he asked was, why is it that somebody that is saved, why is it that the devil will also destroy the person? Does it mean when God said, when you are saved, the devil will not destroy you? Does it mean God is lying? But the problem he had was, he was trying to use salvation as the same thing as born again. Salvation is instant. If you confess Jesus as your Lord and Savior and believe in your heart, according to Romans chapter 10, you are saved. And that's why the Bible says, no one says that Jesus is Lord without the Holy Spirit of God. What is the proof that you are saved? The sign that you are saved, Holy Ghost will just enter you. But if you accept Jesus as Lord Jesus, I accept you as my Lord and personal Savior. Bam! Holy Ghost will enter you. Bam! You are saved. But that's not deliverance. The same way the sons of Sceva had Paul preach, and they confessed Jesus Christ as the Lord and personal Savior, and they were saved instantly, but they went to deliver somebody while they had not been delivered themselves. So born again, where does born again start? After salvation, born again, you start studying the Bible. If you continue in my teaching, you will know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. How will this happen? Paul said in Galatians chapter 2, verse 19 and 20, as I started studying this word, the word started making me free until I died. In verse 20, I am now crucified with Christ. That's born again. When Nicodemus came to Jesus in John chapter 3, Jesus said, unless you're born again, you will not see the kingdom of God. And Nicodemus said, will I enter the... He said, no. But Jesus was saying, you will definitely die. Jesus now said, except you are born of the water and of the Spirit. The water is the word of God, water of worship. And the Spirit is the womb of the church. Unless you enter into the womb of the church and start learning, then you start growing. When you are grown 9 months or whatever in the Spirit, you will be given birth, born again. I said, these are the people that they are celebrating in Nigeria but they don't even know anything about the word of God. And one of their boys that is running around for them came under there and said, in fact, mama, need to remove you. You don't know what you are teaching. If you are saying that salvation is not born again, I say, be it unto you according to your faith. I don't argue with you. Be it unto you. You want to remain a novice? If you want to learn, Archbishop said, I say, I have testimony. The word knows. Man, the Bible says, when the Holy Ghost shall come upon you, you shall receive power, and you shall be a witness. You see, I have received that power, and I've been a witness from Samaria. I have traveled 144 nations. He said, but the foolish one that will not check your level and check what you have achieved, we don't want to learn. Why not have been the one teaching you? Take my own and act your own. Be it unto your ability of faith. You are a judge. So that's why you have to be born again. If you really, Jimmy, I want to change. I want to go to Papua New Guinea and make everybody to be a Christian. What is the first step? It's not when you go there, you start making noise. Repent for the kingdom of God. It's as you're wasting your time. That's why they lock people in China. You go there first and be the first born again person in that community. One day on the bus stop, one day people will ask you, hey, you are my neighbor. Just like, I'm telling you, this God knows, when this coronavirus started or whatever. Ask my wife what happened. Glory was there. My neighbor has been watching me. Nothing has changed. All our activity, everything. My neighbor looked at me and said, you are the only one person that has no care of the world. The only one person I know, I'm talking to you, is an elderly man. He has watched me, he has watched my life, he has watched the way I'm behaving, he has watched everything. He was coming, I was going to drop glory. And that time they have stopped people from going to school. My children didn't want to go stop going to school. They want to go and show the power of God. I can't stop them. So the man looked the whole scenario. Everybody is afraid. Everybody is running under. He said, you are the only one person that I know in the whole entire world that has no care of the world. Me and Glory, we were digesting the English until I went to dictionary and found out there has no care for the world. It means there's nothing happening in the world that bothers you. When I put it on Facebook, somebody living in UK said, if this is true, this digital, your life is supposed to be emulated. Because I'm living as the one born again. That's how to move people. The people that did not see Moses, born again. Did not see Joshua, born again. And the people that were with them, that served with them, when they all died, the people turned against God because they weren't seeing anybody. There's no way a community will get born again without one person that is being born again that they will be looking onto to disciple them. And if that person is faithful, after 3 years, like Jesus, 3.5, he will now introduce them to Holy Ghost. I said, now, we come to Christ, the author. So the first level of being born again or being saved is looking onto one that is born again around you. Am I making sense? And what are the characters of all this? What are the characters of the judges? What's the number one character? Who can remind us?
The judge who
can execute judgment. 1 John chapter 4, verse 17. A judge that knows how to execute what? Judgment. Write down this scripture for me. 1 Timothy chapter 1, verse 8. Remind me, please. A judge that has the ability, that knows how to execute judgment. What's number two? Who can help us? It shouldn't be a Jew, must be a Gentile. A Gentile that knows God, that has renewed his mind, and that his heart is perfect. That was why Jesus said, that was why God can never search in something he has already concluded. God can never search. In 2 Chronicles 16, verse 9, what do you say? For the eyes of the Lord walketh to and fro. Why would God be charging when he has finished everything? Who can answer the question why he was not searching for that opportunity? I made it very clear. I thought it. Right?
Give the Jews. Yeah, not Jews. The Gentiles.
Yeah, what did he do to so that he would bring the Gentiles?
He lowered the Jews.
He himself. The people have chosen to deal, the judge to deal with coronavirus. I'm going to remove them because they are Jews. And I want to bring Gentiles. So God started searching. Anywhere you see God searching, he's searching for Gentiles. The Jews has already been elected. Was that teaching clear? Was that also biblical, or was it just something I brought out from my apple? I show you scriptures. So what's the number three? Who can help us?
Watchman.
And I told you verse 6 of that place is very powerful. Ezekiel chapter 33 verse 6. We're not going to read it. It explains why he needs a watchman and the consequences and whatever and the blessing and the activity. And I came the fourth one. I said, Lord, he must flow out of you. It's not somebody observation that was I say when you have you flowing out of your belly, why go for cup? It must be something you have tasted and proved. Do you know one of the reasons why when I teach I don't look at the Bible? It's coming out of my belly. The word that I've hidden in my heart, I first of all tested and proved it. Oh, church, you don't know. We don't know. If you know where God picked me and where I am today, I'm on the net. My people, that the same community I came from, they are still looking at me like, you know, they saw somebody using the name Ufila. They knew that it was helter skelter, and when they looked at me, when they saw my position, you see, one they couldn't believe it was their brother. They couldn't believe it was somebody from their community. They started putting a lot, 419, somebody is using scam, using our name, scam. And they forgot that nobody, as low as our communities, no rich person will ever think of using their name. What will he be using their name for? It will even be, you know, imagine some people, when they come, they say, they look at my nose. Do you know what? Since I came to Australia till now, no one in Australia has ever gazed right where I came from. I can be a fool and decide to be saying that. They can never. They will come to me first. They don't even ask me. They come and speak proper New Guinea English for me. Or Christian Island English. So it means I'm from the continent of Australia. I look like that. You say, but you just, exactly. When they speak it, I say, I speak my own Nigerian English. You not be here. I not gonna go with you. They say, what kind of pidgin English is that? I said, I'm speaking the pidgin English where I came from before God gave us Biafra. I can pretend to answer, you know, because I can protect it. I'm from Black America. I'm a Black American. Mm-hmm. But that's stupidity. That's foolishness to the core. Mm-hmm. And when they they told my other brother. My other brother had it. My other brother said, "It's my younger brother." Because my family, they know my dad. My dad was a man of great integrity. He was a legend. He didn't have much money, but he had a name in my community. So people started saying, he's a son of Ibe, he's even son. So my other brother said, I'll be telling you, get involved so that they know you. Look at me, they say you are this car, you do that. When I now came to the fold, they added me to the fold. And they started asking me. I humbled myself. I took every question. I took every accusation. After handling it, wow. So Ufili, we have a son like this. And we don't know. No wonder why we doubted when we saw it. And today he brought hope. And when I explained to them, I'm telling you, you were there. I called the guy. He said $450,000. It will support a building and school. How can I take such money when I don't have any income to pay back? I'll be a fool. How will you stand and start fighting? You've not sat down to plan yourself. I said, no. And when I shared this, they started calling me behind. I said, 419 will give you the money. I said, no, but no bagger. No bagger. No man. My money says, it's flowing out of my belly. In church planting, I'm not looking at nobody, I'm not competing with anybody. As I was leaving Nigeria 2004, I was planning to leave Nigeria. I had the last dream, I had. People were coming to the church, our church headquarters, Archbishop, that's where my heart is there. To the extent that, when I was coming, there was no space for me, like almost 100 meters. People blocked the whole place. And when I was coming here, they started shouting, he's the man that God used. He's the man that God used to raise this church. Because that church now, I don't think they have up to 1,000 members. But in that dream, it was more than 20,000. And they came like prayers. What's your secret? What's your secret? What's your secret? What's your secret? I said, Archbishop, don't mind those books. They say 7 ways to build a church, 15 ways to build a church. He said, there's only one way to build a church, prayer at the upper room. And when you pray, what happens? The wind, mighty rushing wind, will go to the community. So I don't know any other way to plant a church except through prayer. Take away prayer from me. Nothing. So first of all, it has to become my lifestyle. And I make sure that none of you will play more than me life. I challenge you. You're going to be greater when in heaven God will give you a big trophy and give me a small trophy. Are you getting it? My trophy will be bigger. My house will have more air condition than your own. Are you getting the point? Church, God bless you. So what I'm trying to say, the fact is that number 4, it has to flow. What's the number, the fifth one? Now, I want to ask you a question. I promise you, I will not. We'll be closing soon. But let me challenge you. Let's see if we can get this one. Who can remember? Just go within 1 minute. Remember those that have really hurt you. that have really hurt you. I'm going to give my own example. And I wish you another person can give his own example. Remember those that have really hurt you, that have really hurt you in something that is too powerful. Have you done that? Don't tell me, just remember it. You think about the people that have really hurt you in this life, made you, you know. Now think about, what is your relationship with them now? Those that have really hurt you. Because this is going to explain how Christian you are. Or how demon you are. I give you an example. You know, when something, there's something more important to me than my family. The vision why God created me. So if you ever hurt me in the vision where God created me, you've hurt me the most. Because vision is eyes. You are just blinding me. If you've ever tried, now think about it. Now a few of you, you know, people that have hurt me, betrayed me in the vision God called me. Oh, you don't understand. I'll give you some example. Because I don't see now, I see the last day. Remember people, look at what we did in Malaysia, me and my wife. At least my wife will be in my shoe to understand this. But how is my relationship with all those people? How do I feel in my heart towards them that have done this evil to me? When we came to Australia here, three ladies, the first one, when we had white people as members, she went and lied, destroyed the church, thinking she can do anything. The church still stood. Sister Katrina still got a copy of the letter. What is my relationship with that lady now? Before we came back from burying my father, she has already printed obituary that CGMi is dead. The guy is dead. Wrote letter, lied against me among my white members. To the extent that when I came, she came with some of the white members, because Australian law, if your church closes, you give it to another church. You say, now your church have closed. I've closed your church. I closed it since 3 weeks. So give me order. She took me to court. She did everything. I can't forget what I told my wife. When my wife started panicking, when she had court, I said, I will not talk to this lady. It's the same members, leaders of the church she felt she has closed. We talked to her. Even in court, I didn't talk to her. She was so much talking that the judge asked, I think this case should not be handled here. It should be handled at the immigration. She lied to me. She called my leader, stoned them against me. I'm giving you these a few examples. The second one, it wasn't the woman. It was a politician that entered into the system. And used, because I went to give David Hall our first fruit. That was how the second church broke. The third one came and said, ladies, Nigerians are making money with church, and I see you are sending money to Africa. Every time you say tithe, 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 building house, I will bring my community so that we will make more money. You will share with me and my husband. And when she found out I'm not that kind of person, she started insulting me. That one was Mother's Day, the last one. The Bible says, I shall overthrow, I shall overthrow, I shall allow you to be overthrown. On the third time. And God was just telling us that youth, that's your assignment here. Now, what are those people? Ask my wife, she has seen me with those people. She has my heart. She's living with me. Okay, typical example. The bishop I bought a car for, he has never in life, it's only now that he's in retirement, maybe he has started understanding my nature, not my abilities, that he started seeing me as a true son, because I bought a car for him. But throughout the time, was the man, if there's any, if I don't have respect in Church of God Mission today, it's him. He has never in the inner caucus said that this guy is a faithful guy. The last time, this was 2018, 2019. Why are you guys treating me? You know, somebody said, what is the problem? What is the problem? What is the problem? The boy is arrogant. Is it? Yeah, we know that. But he does, he's very genuine. Look at his record. Look at everything. The person said, no, this person saying this was inner tackles. He said his spiritual father said he's mad. He's the man who bought coffee. That his spiritual father said he is a mad man. Never you trust him with leadership. Never. He's a mad man. I'm on the net. They were trying to say, oh, he's arrogant, he's this, that, he's that, that. But they said, no, the problem we are having with him, nobody knows him like his spiritual father. If his spiritual father says he's a mad man and he cannot be trusted with leadership, there's no way mama would do that. Mama cannot hear that and do it. Stop wasting your time about that boy. Are you getting it? But yes, me and my wife, we just finished paying the last $250,000 naira, which removed food in our table, just to fulfill the promise we made to Jehovah. I'm trying to bring you to the fifth character of a Danish judge. Now, why do you think I'm doing all these things? I'm a human being. When we are talking, when we are doing this, when I was even paying the money, because Archbishop Margaret said, as I said, forgiveness is not bread wash. I still remember all those things. I still remember when he stopped my wedding. I still remember when he disgraced me, I was ordained as a reverend minister. I still remember what people that should have been hailing me for having planted a church in Malaysia, planted in Australia, doing very well, more than any youth they can ever talk about in international forum. That should have been helping me. Pastor Joseph, they say, we can't trust him. We can never. Because the person that knows him well said this about him. This is one of the hardest character of the next job. That will judge coronavirus. I gave you an example. I asked you to check. Check your own. Check the people that have hurt you. Who are they to you? When you see them, what do you see? You see knife in your bag. You see gun to kill them. A woman looked at me and said, you use juju to get my son that handed over his Honda Legend. 1995, exactly the red color. Cost my father, cost my community, cost everybody, and say, never, you can't even afford. After that time, that was, I couldn't even afford the time. And after costing me, I knelt down and said, God, I've forgiven her. But Lord, this car, I will ride it in my life. I don't have anything against her. I forgave her, became a vision. When I got the car, you saw what happened. Faith was fighting. Faith. It wasn't Australia. I said, no, you can't drive this car here. Faith gave it to me. The next day, I got exactly that car. And that's all. I've forgiven the woman, but at least I've used my, on a good sense, my anger. Not to destroy her. I don't have any time. I don't have. So what do you think is this quality, this character? And I'm telling you, God doesn't reveal to you what enemies are doing to you for you to kill them. If you start killing them, God will never reveal to you again. But God is revealing to you, one, when you're in that position, don't do that. Because you have felt the hurt. I mean, the pen, it didn't turn to hot. I turn my pens into gay. I don't turn them, I allow it to grow to hot. Because if you keep on nursing them to fight, to revenge, it will turn to hot and it will kill you. You can't escape. God said, I can't help you when it's hot. Because it cannot hurt you. But you can turn your pen to gay. So why do you do these things? What is that character that when you have it, and your life will be like, can you read 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 16? Immediately I introduce it, the teaching will be over. Mm-hmm. And I started with something. Don't work with people or consider or fight with people based on their abilities. Receive their nature. Are you getting it? Like, man can fail. Man is weak. What did he say? 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 16.
Take heed unto thyself.
Take heed unto thyself and the teaching.
And unto the doctrine, continuing them.
And the teaching you teach, yes?
For in doing this, yes, thou shalt both save thyself and them that hear thee.
Now, did the Bible make it that save yourself and only save the good people that are hearing? He's talking about every one of them. So that you save yourself and also save even those that have got you. How would they know that Christ is real? How would they know that what you are preaching, God is a merciful God? Because he's not here. You are the one represent. You are the one to show them. You are the one to live the life. What quality will you have that will make you? I know, beautiful, forgiveness. Now, I keep on telling you, what are the hierarchies of faithfulness? What you get when you start serving God? Hierarchy, not really what you get. What has the hierarchy? You can help me understand, explain what I'm talking about. You know what I'm talking about. You know, the first, the greatest, yes. The greatest is what? The Ark. Jehovah, right? When levels of faith, levels of authority. Does that make sense? Jehovah is which God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. What's the next one? I know grace, faith, I know all those stuff, you know. So let's do it. Yeah, you can remember? Okay, God, highest. That's the most powerful, that's the most highest, the powerful thing in heaven and earth. God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. So Jesus is already involved, Holy Ghost is involved. So what's the next thing?
Is it revelation of the word?
You don't know the part of revelation, but that's what I'm teaching you today. It's revelation that can make you live such life. Are you getting that? It's only revelation, divine revelation. And the Bible says in Proverbs chapter 29, verse 18, can you read it? It should be 29:18.
Where there is no vision, the people perish.
Another fashion said prophetic vision. That's like amplified.
Without prophetic vision.
Without prophetic vision. You see now. Now imagine if everybody has been hurting. Just like when you marry my children. What's your dream? Any bad character you see in your wife, it's not bad. God is only helping you to discover if, you remember, your wife is one. So if your members are 200, 200 of them will have that. So if you can't deal it in your deal with it in your home, you can't deal with it in the church. Does that make sense? That's why you have to see her nature, not her ability. Remember, that's why he said, if you have not dealt with that situation in your home, you can't deal with it because it's more in the church. So after you use your gift to get the right woman, and you come out and say, my wife is this, I will be the one to slap you. I will kick you on the altar, use the altar and break your head. Because anything God allows you to see in your wife, one, you're going to see it 20, but I pray it's not going to be, you see, handle it. And I'm telling you, as you're planning with seeing her nature, not her ability, and working towards that, you will see before you know it, you become a champion in the church. You have, if you can't deal with it at all, you can't deal. Does that make sense? Now, how will you deal with that? Jimmy, is only by divine revelation, knowing your end. Show me my end, that I will be able, 39. Verse 4 and 5, Sam, can you read it? Show me my end, God. Knowing my end. I know my end. I know my end from the beginning. Archbishop said outside, you don't know this man in forgiveness. You don't know this man never. He said, he's the one. I even, that was 20, 30 years ago. Archbishop was quoting, he was the one that quoted, let my enemies live long and see what I will be in the future. No more, no man. I have not even beaten him in forgiveness. It was one of his captions. Let my enemies live long and see they can't stop me. Why? He was a man of divine revelation. God has shown him his end. Since my end is fixed, why should I kill every dog that throw stone or back at me? I want them to test God. I want them to see the forgiveness of God. What did he say? Psalms 39, 4 and 5.
Lord, make me to know my end.
Show me my end. That is why I'm different than any of them. That is why I can follow my Ibakush Kabrakatayaba. I cannot. A man of divine revelation, one of the attributes he can never, because he knows his end. And he knows the Bible says it. If you don't forgive, you will not be forgiven. So you will not get to your end. You will not finish well. And along the line, because God has revealed to you people that are hurting you or causing you pain and you are fighting them, no vision again. Your vision has severed. It has ended. Because you have to have the character of Christ. He died for us while we were what? Yet sinners. He's only a man of the fifth character of the judge that will judge coronavirus very well. Because within the time coronavirus comes, a lot of people will hurt you. A lot of people will insult you. Oh, my yaba. There is a video of Moses I love so much. You know, it was recorded that was an Egyptian. And I believe he was the one that was doing that. That followed the children of Israel. It was an Egyptian. So anywhere he complained, he called Moses fool. He saw the Red Sea. And he looked at Moses. He said, you fool. You fool, what do we do now? You fool, he was still asking a fool. You know, Moses' action, he didn't even, Moses did not even hear it. Is it not the same thing like Archbishop said? Because we are there, we don't see all these things. And Moses, the minute Moses turned away from him, left him. But when Moses, God said, Moses, go. He was the one celebrating shout. Now, if Moses had killed him, because Moses had the power, fall and die, boom, the man, boom. Another six people will do it again, fall and die, boom. You will kill every people that God wants you to bring to the kingdom of God. Look at Jesus, the same people that crucified him, most of them are in heaven now. Am I making sense? This will never happen until you touch that level of revelation. Faith, there will not be any faith without revelation. Because actually faith is seeing. If you don't see spiritually, which is divine revelation, forget it. What did the Bible say in Hosea chapter 6, verse 4, verse 6? My people are destroyed. For what? Lack of revelation. Lack of knowledge. Knowledge of the truth. That's revelation. What happened in 2 Kings chapter 6 from verse 15 to 23? What happened? 2 Kings chapter 6, 15 to 20. Elisha's boy came out to do it. They don't have like our toilet here. The Bible says he came out to, and when he was, you know, he was still, he was not fully awake. Then he opened his eyes. The king of Assyria sent all his army to come and capture Elijah. He shouted, he said, "Master, alas! We are gone. Our honor has finished." Elisha closed his Bible and came out. He said, "What is it?" He said, "Look at millions of them." The guy came. Divine revelation. God can never lie. Coronavirus came very late when God has already revealed to me that I still have assignment to do for him in 2025, in 2050. No coronavirus can kill me. And Elisha had the same, and God has already revealed to him that these people will come, or the army of the Assyria will take him. He says, "Small boy, shut up. Those that are with us are greater than those that are against us." And the young man said, "No." He said, "Okay, God opened his eyes, divine revelation, to see that this thing around us cannot harm us, cannot do us anything." And the Bible says his eyes was open, and he saw angels everywhere with the weapon of warfare shining like Voltron, like Superman. And the guy started jumping. "You can't do my master anything. Don't you know who my master is? Elijah, prophet. Prophet of our time, this, that." Are you getting the church? The eyes opened, became powerful. And when Elijah said, because the angels were waiting for Elijah to say, Elijah said, "All of you get blinded." Oh, they were all blinded. He led them to the king's house, the king of Israel. And the king of Israel said, "My Lord," he called Elijah my father. He said, "My father, do you want me to kill all of them?" He said, "You kill only people you want from war. You don't kill the people I want." "Give them food." He said, "What?" "Give them food. I'm going to teach you how to win people, how to win a war." And he gave them food. When they finished eating, he said, "My master, my father, what did I do?" He said, "Send them home to their master." Read the last verse. Can somebody read it for me? Second Kings. Okay. Second Kings chapter 6, 22 and 23. Look at what happened. Look at what happened. How they won the war forever. Mazambolo. Divine revelation. Elisha knew who he was. Are you there?
23.
22, 23.
22. And he answered, "Thou shalt not smite them. Wouldst thou smite those whom thou hast taken captive with thy sword and with thy bow, set bread and water before them, that they may eat and drink, and go to their master." And he prepared great provision for them. And when they had eaten,
what happened?
They drank. He sent them away. And they went to their master.
Listen very well. Are you 23 now?
Yeah, 23.
Listen very well.
So the bands of Syria came to move into the land of Israel.
You spoke in Australian English, sometimes we don't hear. No more. You speak African, no more. Is it no more?
So the band of Syria came no more.
This is African, no more. African English. You say, when he spoke of Australia, no more. You know, we don't. Good. Give it to us. Yeah.
24.
No, 23. Read it again. The whole battle ended.
23. And he prepared great provision for them. And when they had eaten and drunk, he sent them away. And they went to their master. So the bands of Syria came no more.
They came no more. The battle ended.
Into the land of Israel.
Why? Let my enemies live long. Let them live long and see they can never do me anything. It doesn't matter who is planning against me. It doesn't matter, even the Prime Minister of Australia, he can never get me. I have a case to finish. I have things to finish in the next 20 years. No weapon formed against, immediately it becomes a weapon formed against Itika, it will melt in the hand of the enemy. Do you know the reason why I'm doing this? There's only two ways you can be perfect. When you say what God wants you to say. When you bless those that persecute you. I want to be a perfect man before God. I want to be perfect. When people are, you see, everybody, when I do one thing, people start insulting me. But they don't know how perfect I am before Jehovah. And if God has said it, that settles it. Be ye perfect as your heavenly Father. Am I making sense, church? Do you think you are blessed?
Yes.
What are the fifth? I've done the fifth. I'm going to continue with the sixth by next week. The first one is what? You must be a judge that knows how to execute judgment. 1 John chapter 4, verse 6, verse 17. 1 John chapter 4, verse 17. Number two, you must be a Gentile because God is searching. He has already removed the people that are the elect. And he's searching. 2 Chronicles chapter 16, verse 9. Number three, watchman. Ezekiel 33, verse 6. You must be a watchman. And number four, it must flow out of your belly. John 7, verse 37 and 38. And number five, divine revelation. 2 Kings 6, from verse 15 to 23. Church, stand up. You don't know Christianity. I don't know why we are playing with Christianity. The Bible is there as a guide. Are you planning to win all your hearers, or are you planning to win only the hearers that are good to you? God expects you to win everybody, because the same was what Jesus did. While we were yet sinners, what happened? He died for us. Are you getting the church? And also the test we did, I want you to pray for God to give you the strength. If you have not forgiven those that have hurt you, you don't need, it's a heavy load. Remember, you are still moving forward. You don't need to carry all those loads. You are already a success. Imagine, you know, I used to tell my wife, I mean, the people that deal with me, my wife, I say, sweetheart, you know one reason why I'm doing this? The day they want to challenge another pastor, they will ask themselves a question. Is he a type of Pastor Joseph? Or is he a type of the one we have been closing? Because that lady that closed that day, she has closed so many churches here. Any church she enter, you do rubbish. She will first of all enter their camp, the money side. Any you mess up, she will take the money. You know, and you know, African churches here is money. You understand? So, and it was also money that she used to, you know, God rubbish her. Everything, the way God dealt with it. I say one thing, sweetheart, anybody that hit me, it's like hitting a wall. Either you change and go back, or you break your head. And don't forget, the Bible says, if a fool can predict you, you're also a fool. Now I've done this to him, I've hurt him, he's going to come back with cannon gun, he's going to come back with bazooka, he's going to fight this, that, that. A fool can never predict me. The Bible says, if a fool can predict you, you'll be like him. Check all my what my boy did to me in Malaysia. I don't have one thing against him. Don't have. Why is he raised? One day you start before this judgment day of God. Check out what they have done to me in headquarters. My position in Church of Commission International from today. If they do the right thing, my position in the international front doesn't matter. It's not position. God will not say, oh, you coordinator, oh, you bishop. He say, oh, you come faithful servant. Ask God for grace. Nothing that anybody has done to me that will keep me stagnant, that will make me Rick Maroney in ministry. Whatever they have done, Lord, I let it go. I let it go. Just let my enemies live long and see that they cannot stop me. Let anybody fashioning a weapon to destroy me live long. Lord, let them live long, because Jesus is the only way, the truth, and the life. There's no other way we can make it. In Kabbalah, I only decide to rely on Jesus. Lord, thank you for this. Make us so God, people of great revelation. What is the greatest revelation you can have? The revelation of the judgment day. That's the end you can. The revelation of what? The judgment day. When you see the judgment day and you know, Jesus will say, did you forgive? I didn't forgive. You're going to hell. Did you overlook? You didn't overlook. You are going to hell.
But the one you did to me, I forgave you. Why can't you forgive others? That's the greatest revelation. The revelation of the judgment day. Lord, keep it. Make it conscious. Make it, even when we are unconscious, may we understand that there's a judgment day. There's a day a book shall be opened. This person that did this to you, this person that did that to you, how did you treat the person? How did you do that? May the Lord keep you. May the Lord cause his face to shine upon you. May the Lord make you an eternal excellency. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, even as you share the grace of fellowship.